In today's video, we are going to take a more in-depth look at Final Cut Pro's video transition effects. While these visual elements can add a lot to your story, they can easily become disruptive and confusing when overused. Be very careful when using transitions, and only add them if they add to your story. Welcome back to my Final Cut Pro 10 tutorial series. This is part 11 of my complete A to Z tutorial. If you are new to Final Cut Pro, or new to the series, I strongly recommend going back and watching the previous videos. I'll link them in the description, or click the eye in the sky for a complete playlist. If you enjoy this series, please share this video, and don't forget to subscribe. New videos come in every week. Ask any questions you may have in the comments, and either me or someone else watching this video will try their best to answer it for you. So, let's get started. I'll open up Final Cut Pro and open my Bike Adventures project. In part 5 of this series, I briefly showed you how to add a default video transition using a keyboard shortcut. That was only one of the many transition effects included in Final Cut Pro. Click on this transition button to open up Final Cut Pro Transition Browser. Applying and modifying transitions in Final Cut Pro is very similar to applying video effects. The difference is, you apply video effects to clips and you apply transitions to edit points. I'll select the start point of a clip in my timeline and use Command-T to apply a default cross-dissolve transition. When the transition needs to be applied to both the start and the end of a clip, I can save time by selecting a clip and using the Command-T shortcut. The cross-dissolve transition is applied to the start and end of my clip at the same time. So far, these transitions were easily applied because of the existence of media handles in my clips. Media handles are extra source material at the start and end of my clips. Final Cut Pro uses some of this extra source material for the transitions, so the timing doesn't change. When I select the endpoint of this clip, the clip's endpoint bracket is red. This indicates there is no media handle at the end of this clip. I can still apply a transition, but my content may suffer. Let's try it and see how Final Cut Pro handles it. I'll select the endpoint of this clip and apply a default transition to it. A warning dialog box pops up, warning me about the no media handle available for this transition. It asks me if I want to ripple trim my clip to complete my transition request. I'll click on the Create Transition button while watching my timeline. Final Cut Pro ripple trims my clip to create the necessary media handle for my transition. Sometimes this is not a big deal, but if your edit point is synced with music or another clip, ripple trimming may create an undesirable edit, which is why the warning dialog box appeared. Since my cuts are synced with my background music, I don't want to ripple trim my clip. I'll press Command-Z to undo this. But there's another solution, the slip edit. From the Tools pop-up menu, I'll select the Trim tool. For more information on using the Trim tool and performing slip edits, check out Part 5 of my tutorial series. I'll slip my clip 15 frames to the right, which will give me enough media handle to add a transition to my clip. I'll press A to go back to the Select tool, select the endpoint of my clip, and press Command-T to add a transition. When you have a clip that needs a transition without sufficient source material for a media handle, you can either apply a transition at the expense of losing content under the transition, or slip edit your clip to create a media handle without affecting the timing. Now, let's check out the transitions browser. Just like video effects, Final Cut Pro has many video transitions included. More can be downloaded, or you can even create your own custom one and save it. In the transitions browser, you can preview the transitions by skimming over them. Pressing spacebar will preview the transitions in real time. Pressing Ctrl-T will apply a default transition, which at the time is cross-dissolve. You can apply different transitions by first selecting the edit point and double-clicking on the transition. Also, if you find a transition you want to use repeatedly in your video, you can save time by making that your default transition and applying it with a keyboard shortcut. For demonstration purposes, I'm going to use a slide transition. In the browser search box, I'll type in slide. Now, I'll right-click on the slide transition and select Make Default. I'll select an edit point in my timeline and use Command-T to add a transition. Just like video effects, each transition has its own parameters that can be modified. First, you can modify the duration of your transition by clicking and dragging the endpoints. When you hover the mouse pointer over the transition end, two tools appear, Ripple Trim tool and a Resize tool. Resize tool modifies the duration of your transition, and Ripple Trim tool, indicated by the film strip, ripple trims your clip. You can also use the dashboard to select a specific duration. Select your transition and press Ctrl D. Now you can enter a timecode to set the duration of your transition. You can also modify your transitions in the inspector. Place the playhead over the transition and select it. Now click on the inspector button to open the transition inspector. Any parameters attached to a transition can be modified here. For my selected transition, I can adjust the type and the direction of the slide. I can also use the control points in the viewer for custom direction of the slide. Each transition has its own parameters for adjustments, and just like video effects, the possibilities are endless. Like I mentioned at the start of this video, using too many transitions can make the video seem very unprofessional, so use cautiously. Also, using too many different transitions can confuse and frustrate the viewer, so try to stick to similar ones in your video. If you like this video, make sure you check out the rest of the series. Likes, comments, and subs are always appreciated, and sharing this video will help me reach more people. So hit that share button below. Thanks for watching, and until next time.